Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from TechFanciers. In this quick video, we will be seeing how to install the latest stable Android 10 GSIs on ASUS Zenfone Lite L1, Live L1 and Live L2. There is no new process or method or trick involved on this. It is like installing every other Android Pie GSIs on top of an Oreo vendor. So let's get started. Currently, I'm using Zenfone Oreo, not the latest one. It's old, like February 2019. So why I'm choosing this build is most of the or all the PHS GSIs works well on top of this build's vendor. If you are unable to find this build or something, just install the any of the Zenfone Oreo builds as per your device chipset. Lite L1 users use 8937 and Live L1 users use 8917. I'm having a confusion with L2, but still they can check their device chipset by installing ZCPU and install the builds accordingly, which was released on February 2019. For Lite L1 users, if you feel hard to find them, you can use fastboot ROM and install by watching the video in the I button. Hope it's clear. Any doubt, feel free to comment below. Don't install wrong firmwares. It will heartbreak your device. Don't do that. Now I am rebooting my device to recovery. Here I'm using old TWRP recovery, which I showed how to install in this video. So if you are using Black Peach recovery or Orange Fox, I suggest you to use this recovery as it is the one supporting the Muggies installation on latest GSIs. Hope that's clear. Now go to wipe and format the data. It takes some time, so please be patient. Once it's done, go to Advanced, select Dalvik, Data, System and Cache. Swipe to wipe. Now come to home screen and go to Install and select Install IMG. For this tutorial, I am using Havoc OS 3.5. Select and install as system. I also have Oreo vendor in the folder in the link. It is for Lite L1 users, not for Live L1. If you are unable to download fastboot ROM or something, like you don't want to waste 2GB, you can flash this as a vendor. Now for me, it is not required as I am already in Oreo vendor or Oreo firmware. So now I am installing the GSI boot loop patch. This will set the permissions. After that, I am installing Muggies Manager. I always recommend you to use Muggies in order to enable the bank apps and camera to API and get the root access. It's not normal Muggies, it's made for PHS GSIs. Now clear cache and things, then reboot to system. Usually the first boot won't mount the system, so it reboots again, so don't panic. As you can see, the boot animation appears, so the mug is installed correctly. If it is not, then it won't boot the system. That's all. Finally, we have installed the Havoc OS 3.5. You can install any other official GSIs using this method. That's what about this video. Leave a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to this channel to support and encourage this work. If you have any queries and concerns, feel free to follow on our Instagram and DM me. Thank you for watching. Code Mutt out.